Welcome to Ezekiel's Landing Special Edition. I'm James Treacle. I directed this film back in 2014. It was a labor of love for everybody involved, and all the passion and talent that was poured into it is something that I wanted to honor with this new version that I think is dramatically better than what we released 6 years ago back on this date, April 25th, in 2015. This new version is a little bit shorter, but includes more of the content that we had intended to include in the film. It's much truer to the original script. The stakes are higher, the relationships between the characters feels much stronger. What I'm bringing to the film now is many more years of professional experience. When I worked on the film initially, I didn't really know what I was doing as my first feature, and it was the first really big substantial project that I had sunk my teeth into as an editor. So being able to edit the film now, I'm discovering that there's actually a much, much better film in there than I even knew at the time, which says a lot about the cast and crew, again, and everything that they brought to the table. So this is my love letter to them, my thank you to them for everything that they put into it. And if you love sci-fi movies and you love indie movies, you will get a huge kick out of this movie. I'm so excited for everybody to see this. Please enjoy. Thank you.
Experiments continue to bear out interesting results. The most interesting of which is that I have just asked Professor Linus to marry me.
Oh, when you call me Professor Linus, it sounds really awkward.
Power, baby, power.
We finally have something tangible from the sequence. It looks like a sustained burst at 23 kilohertz, right on the edge of human hearing. It goes...
That means it's time?
Yep. That's time.
Joe will be very excited to go.
Yeah, I know he will. He told me he wants to be an astronaut. He'll do it too. He's a bright boy. We're gonna go for it. Ezekiel's landing, here we come.
Dr. Wright, we're recording. Welcome to episode 234 of the Skeptics Armory podcast. I'm your host, Joel Hooper. Here with me today is Dr. Emma Wright, author of the very well-written, consistently entertaining, but complete bullshit story, Sailing the Black Ocean, My True Contact Experience. Now, Dr. Wright has agreed to this interview because she, and I totally, honestly admire this, wants to foster open dialogue between the skeptic community and UFO hunters such as herself. Welcome, Dr. Wright.
Glad to be here, Joel.
I'm going to come right out and say it. At the end of the day, this whole UFO phenomenon business is nothing more than mass hysteria repackaged to sell shit to ignorant people. However, I will admit that for some people it is a matter of faith.
It's not a matter of faith for me.
No?
No, it's not. It's a matter of experience. Haven't you read the book?
Yeah, I have. But then again, I do myself the favor of not believing everything that I read. Now, it's clear to
don't
me...
Don't you have your own abduction story?
All right, you've done your research, but it's clear to me, Dr.
Tell
Wright...
me about it. I mean, I already know it, but for the benefit of the listening public...
It's not much to tell.
So you deny that it ever happened?
No, I'm saying that the version of the story that you dug up, Doctor, is how a boy as young as I can't even believe I am actually discussing this with you. It's how a kid like me processes parental abandonment. We make up monsters to mask the real ones.
So you're saying that everybody who believes in UFOs or has had a contact experience is using that belief as a band-aid for some trauma or emotional weakness?
I couldn't have said it better myself.
That's pretty arrogant. All due respect to your own trauma, it's a cookie-cutter dismissal of experiences you can't explain. You're not alone, Joel. You don't have to lie to yourself.
Look, I made up the abduction story as a kid so that I wouldn't have to face the truth about my father. Now, I'm sorry if I don't place much stock in hypnosis because I don't get all of my scientific information from daytime television. No offense to your degree and whatever the... I'm sorry, what did you study again, even?
Your father was a paranormal researcher as well, wasn't he? Look, I understand why you reject this stuff, but to deny your own story...
I think you had a particularly vivid dream, Emma. That's it.
Believe what you want to believe. The truth is out there.
Why would you do that, Mom?
Right.
Who the hell are you?
Kass Burroughs. Saw your lecture on campus. Been following you around all day.
Flattered.
Read your book. Got something for you. I think you deserve it. Possible proof of alien life. Figure if anybody would know the real thing, it'd be you.
Proof.
What do you make of that, Doc?
Mathematically, it's consistent across TV, radio, internet. So, you didn't see anything that looked like that when you were, you know, up there?
annoying.
Impulsive.
No, I've never seen anything quite this. Whatever this is. So you say it's mathematically consistent. What do you mean?
Meaning that the data that generates these images, it's the same in audio files, even streams of binary. It's identical. Like the, it's adapting to fit whatever possible way it could be received. Okay, your dishes are gross, by the way.
Mathematically consistent, infinitely, it does get to be heard, but you know.
But do you think it's, you know, them? You would know.
No, I wouldn't necessarily.
Why not? And the way you wrote it sounded pretty intimate. Like, it was quite the experience.
It was. When did you make this?
Well, if you don't know where the signal's coming from, I think I know somebody who does.
Do you know?
But this information's in a private archive, and the best time to go, if you wanted to break in, would be right now.
Doc! Do you copy? This is stupid. Do you need more coffee? No, Kass, I don't need any more coffee. The walkie-talkies are stupid.
Well, the fact that I'm breaking into the security cameras is basically a technicality. There's nobody here. No guards, no nothing.
Kass, when I'm caught and killed.
Disavow all knowledge.
Go get him, Doc.
That girl, your driver, we have a bomb under her car. Really? Did I just happen to have some chloroform laying around? Or do I work for some really scary, powerful people?
Aeronautics and Airborne Phenomena Archive? It's pretty obvious code for we study UFOs.
Tell me, who gave you the lead on 0427? And I will kill her.
Let's suppose I also work for some scary, powerful people.
I doubt it.
But that I'm alone on the totem pole, and I don't know anything. So they sent me here to snip it out. Expose your weaknesses, call your bluffs. What do you think about that, Professor? Yeah, I know your type. Academic, over the hill, divorced. No, widowed. And feeling so much out of her depth right now, doing a poor impression of a comic book villain. So, am I just perceptive? Or who do I really work for exactly?
Tell whoever it is that you work for that the situation just got a whole lot worse.
Bullshit.
Is it?
She just got a whole lot worse. Or so she says.
So does that mean that you work for me? Look, I'm trying to show you what the signal actually looks like.
Miss Burroughs, where exactly did you get that lead on the file?
So operator 001 has no posting history on the forum. My guess is they're a lurker. Only PMing people like me who for some reason they decide to trust.
She was clearly lying to me about what was in that file.
The aliens are friendly. Right.
Well, yeah. They're just... they're aliens. They're just sort of...
careful of these for information.
Listen, Kass. I don't...
what?
When they took me, it was like seeing the face of God. Everything I know, everything I felt, it's in that book. There's nothing more I experience up there which I can put into words. In a way, I'm just as ignorant as you are. Which is why I think I need you. I need you because you believe. You make me want to keep on searching. Because I was up there, Kass, and while I'd give anything to go back, I have a feeling that discovering the truth behind the signal might be the closest I ever get to the stars. So?
Okay. Let's go save the world.
You know, whatever she's hiding, I doubt it's that serious.
Take me home. When was your last, you know, attack?
I think I'm still having it. They're getting worse, Joel. I'm seeing things. Familiar things.
I think we need to meet. Right now.
What do we know for sure? The sequence of 23 symbols repeating endlessly.
What the hell do they mean?
What if it's a distress call?
And I can definitely sympathize with them.
Thank you.
setting the signal sequence to audio 23 kilohertz.
Any particular reason why?
I think we're gonna blow something up.
You should know, Sheriff Lucas has been looking for you. Not that you're in any trouble. He's just wondering if you might have, you know, noticed anything.
Noticed what?
You know if you see anything weird, right?
It's been 3 weeks, and they're getting worse.
3 weeks? What did you see?
Their images, just floating around my room, and our implants.
So whatever it is, you think it's rooted in your, you know, your childhood trauma?
Joel, what are you doing? I'm trying to come up with a rational explanation for this. No, asshole! You're in denial!
Have you told your brother about this?
I understand you were the one who lost the most that night. But don't pretend that what happened to you and your friends, dammit, was imaginary.
Mike. Sorry.
No, you're not sorry, Joel. You just want me to stay here so you can convince me that I'm crazy. That I'm the one with the problems. And you want to know why? So you don't have to confront the truth about what happened to you and what's happening now.
All right, I saw something. I saw my dad. He said,
take me home.
This is crazy.
Yeah, no shit. We were abducted by aliens, man.
Okay, all right. Something happened to us. Something real. But Jesus, man. Going for the absolutely most absurd possible interpretation every time.
They're going to kill us, man. If this thing doesn't kill us first. If you want to stop all this, meet me again tonight.
Where?
Ezekiel's landing.
I can't go back there. Mike? I said I can't go back!
Do you think Operator 001 works for the government?
I think she used to, but now she wants us to know the truth about the signal.
Which is...
Hey, Max. Sorry to just drop in like this, but we need to talk about Mike. Your brother, he thinks somebody's after him.
Think you'd better come in.
Excuse me for a moment. Sorry.
Hey, Max!
This dagger! Is this custom made?
Why can't you just say hello?
Aren't you in jail?
The sheriff and I have an arrangement.
Oh, you guys are adorable.
You've heard the call.
Why didn't you come to us? Even Mike came and... poor dear scared out of his skull.
Yeah, what did you tell him?
That if he doesn't answer the call and join us in defending the emissary, we'll be forced to defend the emissary from him.
You said it yourself. He's just a scared kid. He's no threat to you. Max, he's your brother, goddammit!
Sometimes love hurts.
So who is this emissary? To your prophet? Huh? Is he the one that organized this whole low-rent Heaven's Gate?
Sit down. Sit down. Sit down!
Sit down. You've been lying to yourself for too long, Joel. You belong with us. You belong with the emissary. He longs for you.
Listen to me. I know that whatever happened to us that night, all those years ago, whoever orchestrated it, it fucking hurts, okay? I get it. But I moved on. I built my own life because I realized that I don't have to be defined by my trauma.
So you admit you have an implant? That you were taken?
Your entire life is defined by what they gave you that night, and you know it. A podcast that nobody listens to, an estranged mother who tried her best to help you. How many doctors did it take before Jane gave up on the implant? This isn't a wound to be healed. It's a gift that must be accepted.
Know something? Even if it's true, even if this call is driving us all crazy, it doesn't change the fact that you were a sick fucking lunatic from the beginning.
Thank you.
Dr. Wright speaking.
Dr. Wright. I'm listening.
Kass! Kass! Come on, get up. We gotta go.
Doc, what's going on?
Another breakthrough. I'm going to cast it.
Right now?
Joe Hooper called me.
Did you tell him to shove it up his terrestrial?
He's in trouble. He specifically asked for my help.
Whoa.
It's the signal, Kass. We found it. It's in Kasdan.
I never taken you for the bender type. It's them kooks. I mean, Natasha and them kooks. And that girl wants to have fun. She killed Wright. What? I said she killed Mike Berg. Tonight at Ezekiel's Landing.
Sorry.
I know you and the deputy had some times. But are you really going to be so bitter that you're going to make up shit about her? Jesus, man. Not cool. You're right. I should let it go.
Forgot to mention, I listened to your podcast. The way you took that bitch huckster down. Priceless. I say, fuck her.
Wow. That was suspiciously good timing.
I'd say so.
Count the stars.
What?
Kass, how many stars are in the Big Dipper?
Seven.
Count the stars, Kass.
Oh my God.
Kass, look.
There's some kind of spatial temporal distortion right at the border. And I think it's because they're almost here.
Natasha King.
Emma Wright.
Dr. Emma Wright, the contactee. The real thing. Won't you sign up for me, Doctor?
Really don't have time.
Doctor, won't you sign it? I must have read it cover to cover at least a dozen times.
I'm flattered. Why did you lie, Doctor? I'll tell you why.
Who are you?
Well, it would have started with thank you first, at least.
You know me as Operator 001.
It's about time you showed up. Nice trick with the speaker.
The signal is a distress call, lethal to abductees who have received an implant. But to Peter Hooper, who like me was returned to Earth in an ageless state but forever altered in spirit, its broadcast is a necessary evil. He wants them to come back for him, and he doesn't care who gets hurt along the way.
What are we supposed to do?
Peter's wife, Jane, researched the signal for years. I'm certain she has a file that can tell you how to stop the signal. Find Jane, find Peter, and shut the signal down. Please, Doctor, you have to save us. While there's still time.
Wait. You gotta tell me. Are they really coming back?
Say it.
I got a bad feeling about this.
Hello?
I'm sorry.
How long have you been standing there?
Not long. Well, long enough to know that you look rather lost. You know where you're going,
yes?
Whew! You won't need that. I don't think. It's not quiet.
We're looking for 113 Carter Lane. Do you know where that is?
This way.
Coming in through everything.
Kass, shut off your phone.
You got it, Doc.
I'm really glad you guys are here. I can't trust anybody in this town.
Anything for a friend.
You have to tell me, how'd you do it? How'd you remove the implant, Doctor?
It was a long time ago.
No. You'd remember a thing like that. Please. Tell me how.
There was never an implant, Joel.
I know. But I wanted to believe. Really was a damn good book.
It was a damn good dream. I've had them ever since I was little. Very lucid. Very beautiful. Sometimes, very disturbing dreams. This was the worst. And the best. They felt so real that I had to believe that the book was. I wanted to know if there was something actually tangibly real out there. So I wrote the book, hoping that it would open doors. People would confide in me, that at least vicariously I could capture that feeling again. Being caught up and taken away.
Kass! I'm sorry.
I need a drink.
I should probably go after her.
You can't just leave me here. At least stay till morning.
After what I just told you, why would you ask me to stay?
Because you might be a dirty, rotten liar, Doc. But it takes one to know one. Why don't we start over? Joel Hooper, denial expert.
I'm a Wright. Professional liar.
Tired and I wanna go to bed.
Had a little
about an hour ago.
And it went straight to my head.
Show me the way to go home. I'm tired and I wanna go to bed. Had a little drink about an hour ago. And it went straight to my head. Grocery store's closed. Mine.
On a scale of 1 to 10, how drunk are you?
0.
I'm like a 3.
How far do you plan to go tonight?
As far as I can.
Since we're not dead yet, Joe, you have to help me help you. So, let's start simple. Where's your mother?
Feel it coming and going in waves.
Do your parents take many home movies, Scully?
Not that I remember. Mulder?
Well, our experiments continue to bear out interesting results.
Holy shit.
How about some entertainment while we work? Hudson. Hello, operator.
At 23 kilohertz, right on the edge of human hearing, caused some serious damage.
That means it's time?
Yep. That's time. Go for it. Ezekiel's landing, here we come.
All right, can you turn this off
can't
or something?
Can't explain why we're setting up the EL?
Ezekiel's landing is an old, abandoned military landmark. It was evacuated after the incident that turned it in the local town of Kass into a UFO hotspot.
Joe will be very excited to come.
Yeah, I know he will. He told me he wants to be an astronaut. Do it too. He's a bright boy.
Joe, these dates on the blueprint.
What?
They're from 6 months ago.
The hell are these?
According to the blueprints, they're resonance bars designed to block out the signal.
Wait a minute. They were building a place where he could operate the signal, completely immune to its effects.
They knew it was dangerous,
But they didn't care.
And we know where they built it.
We have to stop him, Joel.
Yeah, no shit? Less after seeing you drive a knife through Mike's chest.
At least I had the balls to do it. What about you, Joe? You got the balls to kill me?
Let me come down, Joe. Hi, Mom. Come with me. Make peace with your father.
It's time to forgive.
Did you tell her what the signal does to the implant? I don't know about you, Natasha, but I want to live.
Drop the gun.
I'm not gonna shoot you, Sheriff. I'm just gonna pull it out. I'm gonna remove the clip. I'm gonna slide it towards you, okay? Whoa, whoa, whoa! Okay, I'm going slow. Take it easy. Relax.
You can do something. Stop this.
How are you doing today, officer?
Why are you helping them? Hell, why are you helping Peter after what he did to your son?
We did to our son is give him a revelation of a much bigger universe than what this world can ever show.
Do you honestly believe that was for his own good? You let them experiment on him.
Fuck.
Joel's gonna see his father again.
Peter's dead, Jane. When he came back after all those years with them, he wasn't the same man. Sure, he didn't age, but inside, your husband's gone, Jane Hooper. Are you willing to lose your son too? Or are you going to do the right thing for a change?
Jane, get back in the car!
Keep the gun down.
Jane!
Hey! One in the chamber, asshole.
Thank you.
Kass.
I just killed a man. I am not in the mood for an apology.
Thank you.
For what?
For believing in me.
Whatever, Doc.
Please don't call me that.
Okay, fuck you. You're my friend. I will call you whatever the hell I want, even if you lied about having a doctorate or seeing aliens or being a genuine... whatever. Let's go save some people.
Let's.
Charlie's Angels. Put him up. Man, I am pissed off and scared and shit. Put him up.
Kass. Okay. Come on, everybody, put him in. One, two, three, go team Earthling. Go team Earthling, okay? One, two, three, go team Earthling.
Let's go!
Shut that loop off.
What the hell are these?
They're resonance bars. They block out the signal.
Ooh, so they match the frequency and adapt it to get...
It adapts.
Since the Hudson signal cycles through new frequencies every few seconds, and the resonance bars, they absorb sequence data.
Like a lightning rod, except smart.
Really?
Bet you had to blow up a lot of kitchenware to get that to work.
You have no idea. Anyway, these are just prototypes. Peter's got the original set, the only working set. Getting them operational will take a full day's work. And there's no guarantee that they will protect Joel when the signal is this intense.
No, not just Joel. We are going to save everybody. Everybody received an implant and who's been driven crazy by that signal. If you hadn't called the aliens that night, Professor, if you hadn't been so utterly selfish in your pursuit of knowledge, no one would have been taken.
Wouldn't be a murderous psychopath now.
So let's get the voices out of our heads. Hudson said the key to stopping the signal is in the fire.
We've studied it for years. The only way to save somebody from its effects is to block the transmission frequency.
What if you answered it?
Doc, we've never even figured out what it means, let alone how to respond.
We know what it means.
We do?
It's a simple distress call. Roughly, it translates, take me home.
Fantastic, Professor. Now consider this. It's intelligent, right? It's not just a sequence, it's a mimetic virus.
Thanks. It's doing everything it can to be hurt, right? So if we answer it, then it could interpret it, like,
and then shut itself down.
We have to mask the new signal with the old one. If it didn't learn the new code fast enough, it could intensify the signal and kill everybody you're trying to save.
We are trying to save.
Dad?
Hey, Joel. Here we are again. The signal's too intense. You step out there, that implant explodes in your brain. Like a little bomb going off.
What about the others? Your cult. If you leave them out there...
It doesn't matter.
What?
I said it doesn't matter. We don't need them anymore. They think they're gonna fly away, oh glory, fly away. But the truth is that they're going to die before the travelers get here. Which is sad. But they've gone crazy. They've killed people. It's not like they deserve anything less. Look, Joel, I'm back. And this time, you're going with me.
So you're just using them the way you used me.
Son, let's go see the universe. Together.
Joel's in the capsule, he's safe.
Don't back out on me now, Professor.
I guess I'm in for good, Doctor.
You know I'm not actually a scientist, right?
Bullshit.
Let me through.
Do you not realize what they did to me?
They're explorers. Scientists. If I was gonna go with them, they had to have some knowledge in return.
So, let me get this straight. You monstrous fuck! You let them experiment. on your only child so you could go for a ride?
You have no idea what it was like. If she only knew how beautiful it was, how can I go back to a life on this dying thing?
You can't go back now, because we don't want you. I don't want you. How'd it feel when they abandoned you the way you abandoned me?
Years that I've been gone, you'll learn to forgive me.
There's some things you don't forgive. I'm glad you got left. Mulder.
Hey, Scully.
Seems so strange that something so spectacular would seem so familiar.
Do you remember when you told me you wanted to be an astronaut?
The events at Ezekiel's landing, while world-changing to those who experienced them, never reached an official investigation from any government agency. Not any known government agency, that is. All evidence, all the signal equipment, and years of Hooper's research were seized within 48 hours. The surviving members of Peter Hooper's cult vanished without a trace the moment the Traveler's light disappeared. Jane Hooper, her secrets exposed, finally moved on from casting. Cassandra Burroughs, paranormal investigator extraordinaire, left her duplicitous mentor behind, confident now in her own experience of the truth. And Emma Wright, no longer a fraud, stayed a while in casting, determined to plumb its remaining secrets. The help of a new ally. She hopes that one day she'll get a little bit closer to the stars. But as for the truth is right here.